الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. وقال تعالى: شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم. وقال عز وجل: إنه من يتق ويصبر فإن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين. وأن عبادة بن الصامت رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: يوما وحضرنا رمضان أتاكم رمضان شهر بركة يغشاكم الله فيه، فينزل الرحمة ويحث الخطايا ويستجيب فيه الدعاء، ينظر الله تعالى إلى تنافسكم فيه ويباهي بكم ملائكته، فأروا الله من أنفسكم خيرا، فإن الشقي من حرم فيه رحمة الله عز وجل، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. رواه الطبراني. صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم رب زدني علما، يا حي يا قيوم، برحمتك نستغيث. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما. Respected and honorable ulama ikram, respected elders, colleagues, friends, young children of Islam, and honorable listeners listening at home, I would first and foremost like to greet you with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This holy month of Ramadan, as we all know, is a month of blessing, a month of forgiveness, a month in which we need to strive, not only strive, but strive hard in trying to gain from the treasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Rabbul Izzah has ordained fasts upon us in this holy month of Ramadan, we need to evaluate our lives. We need to see, is there a difference coming into my lifestyle? Am I creating the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? Because the whole purpose of fasting is quite clear in the Quran. Allah is saying to me and you, all you people who believe, fasts have been ordained upon you like they were ordained on the people before you, so that you may become Allah conscious, subhanAllah. Taqwa, the conscience of Allah. In another word, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should come into us. The realization that Allah is watching us. This is important for us. If we do not have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we are failing in fulfilling the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah doesn't want me and you just to stay hungry. He doesn't want me and you to stay thirsty. He just doesn't want me and you at the time of fasting to stay away from having a relationship and cohabitating with our partners. That is a condition of fasting. This is shurutus sawm. These are conditions. If I was to say, Muhammad, why don't you have a drink of water whilst you're fasting? He said, Mawlana, you're mad. How can I drink? I'm fasting. Yeah. If I say, Muhammad, Ya Abdullah, Ya Abdurrahman, if I say, Ya Zainab, Ya Fatima, Ya Aisha, why don't you eat something in Ramadan? Go have a cheese party. Yeah? Go on, have a cheese party in the town center. So Mawlana, you're mad. إِنَّكَ لَمَجْنُونَ huh? You are a mad man. You're telling me to eat something in the holy month of Ramadan. Why are we going to say this? Because we know we're not supposed to eat. We know we're not supposed to drink. We know we're not supposed to have a relationship with our wives during fasting. We know for the fact of life. But let's think for a minute. These things were already halal for us. Huh? At this moment in time, we can eat because we're not fasting. At this moment in time, we can drink because we're not fasting. At this moment in time, we can have a relationship with our partners because we are not fasting. We have broken our fast now. And both things that are halal for us to do at other times have become haram for us during fasting. But why are we not considering those things which were already haram? To look at a non-mahram is already haram for us. To listen to music is already haram for us. To lie is haram. To slander is haram. To backbite is haram. To give remarks which degrades a person, which hurts a person's feelings, to swear, to slander, to rebuke others for no reason, it's all haram and forbidden in the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why is it, Ya Abdullah? Why is it, Ya Abdurrahman? Why is it, Ya Fatima? Why is it, Ya Zainab? Why is it, Ya Aisha, that when you are not fasting, it was halal for you to eat, it was halal for you to drink, it was halal for you to do these things, but because you're fasting, you are conscious of this. You are saying, I'm not going to do this because I'm fasting. But why is it that those things which were already haram for us before we were fasting, we are still doing them whilst we are fasting? La ilaha illallah. In the month of Ramadan, we have a habit of sitting maybe some people نعوذ بالله من ذلك in the house of Allah. Maybe some people when they get together and do some religious activity, we have a habit of nitpicking. We have a habit of backbiting. At the back of the masjid, we'll sit around and we'll backbite La ilaha illallah in the holy month of Ramadan. Why are we, Ya Abdullah, Ya Fatima, depriving ourselves from the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This fasting is a message for me and you that we have to create the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the conscience of Allah? Hazrat Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was once asked a question by Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And he asked him a question. He said, ma huwa taqwa? Is taqwa which the Khatib mentions week in and week out in his khutbah, this taqwa regarding which I do not think any khutbah in the face of this earth on a Friday is without the name of taqwa. Every khatib will say, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullah. Why is it that we have not understood the meaning of this important word which Allah has mentioned many, many places in the Holy Quran? And in some verses, Allah has mentioned it twice, subhanAllah. In one verse, Allah mentions it twice. Ubay ibn Ka'b is asked this question by Amir al-Mu'mineen, ma huwa taqwa? Hazrat Amir al-Mu'mineen, before getting the answer, Ubay poses a question to him. And Ubay radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, hal akhadta tariqan dha shawkin? Have you ever walked a path which is thorny, which has got prickles? Qala na'am, says yes. I have walked on such a path which is thorny, which has got prickles. Mada amilta fi? What did you do at that time? What was your immediate reaction? What did you do when you were walking this kind of a path? Amir al-Mu'mineen said, tashammartu wa hadartu. What would I do? I would gather my clothes so that they don't get tangled with the pricks, and I would walk cautiously so that these pricks don't get my body and I don't feel the pain. Ubay ibn Ka'b looks at Amir and says, qala fadhaka taqwa. You asked me the question, ma huwa taqwa? You have given me the answer yourself, Amir al-Mu'mineen. This is the meaning of the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that basically we live our lives in such a way that we protect ourselves from those things which Allah and His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have forbidden us to do. We protect ourselves from all these things which are going to prick us, which are going to be dangerous for us, which are going to be detrimental to our iman. We protect ourselves from all these things. This is the definition of taqwa and the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes dua in one hadith. And what did he say? Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha. Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha. Wa zakkiha wa anta khayru man zakkaha. أنت وليها ومولاها. Oh Allah, grant my nafs, grant my soul your conscience, subhanAllah. Grant my nafs, Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha, the taqwa which my nafs should have. This is the dua of, who's making this dua? Rasulullah, so where does that leave me and you? We should be asking for taqwa from Allah. Have we ever asked for taqwa? We want to ask for money, because we feel funny. Money, money, honey, makes me funny. We want to ask for money. But we don't ask for taqwa. We don't want to ask for piety.
No more talk. I don't want to become religious. I'm young. I don't want to do what I like at the moment. When I become old, when I become a haji, and then a qaji, I'm going to get the tasbih. I'm going to sit in the masjid. And subhanallah, subhanallah. Because I've reached my old age and I'm reserved. I'm young. Let me have fun. Let me have fun, haji. Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha. Oh Allah, grant my nafs its conscience of yourself. وَزَكِّهَا Purify it. أَنْتَ خَيْرُ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا For you are the best. You purify Allah. The one who will purify our souls is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَنْتَ وَلِيُّهَا وَمَوْلَاهَا Ya Allah, you are its guardian and you are its master subhanallah. This is the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it's very important that this month of training, we don't waste it. Every aspect of life has a season. And the season for our spiritual nourishment is Ramadan. Is it? Ramadan. This is a month from Allah where the mercy is descending upon us 24/7. Not one second is deprived or stopped from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But are we running to achieve this mercy of Allah? That's what me and you need to understand and think and contemplate on. Listen to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding this holy month. The narrator is Ubad ibn Samit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. What does he say? He says one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and he said it at such a time where Ramadan was already here. And he says, أَتَاكُمْ رَمَضَانُ شَهْرُ بَرَكَةٍ The month of Ramadan, the month of blessing has come unto you. يَغْشَاكُمُ اللَّهُ فِيهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn towards you, subhanallah. رحمت کا مہینہ برکت کا مہینہ آیا اللہ تمہاری طرف توجہ کرتا ہے اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی turns to you فَيَنزِلُ الرَّحْمَةِ and then he descends his special mercies upon you سبحان اللہ وَيَحُطُّ الْخَطَايَا he forgives the sins وَيَسْتَجِيبُ فِيهِ الدُّعَى he accepts your prayer عجیب واللہ اللہ رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم further says ينظر الله تعالى إلى تنافسكم فيه Allah looks at your competition with each other in this holy month subhanAllah. He says Allah is looking how much are my servants competing with each other in righteousness. We like to compete with each other in many other things. If he's got this kind of a car, I'm going to get one which is better than that. There's no harm in having a good car unless until you do not have the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there is arrogance and pride and vanity, that is of not benefit neither to you and neither for your akhirah. But if you possess a nice car but you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this ni'mah, Allah will increase in that ni'mah. We compete with each other. Oh, if he is like this, I'm going to be like that. If he is there, I'm going to be there. We don't look at people less fortunate than we are. We always look at people better than we are. We say, oh, I'm still so behind in the world. This guy has reached so far in the worldly aspect. I'm only there. I need to try more. I need to put more effort so I can gain more. And we don't look at the people which are less fortunate than we are. We should be looking at those people who are more in righteousness than we are and then try to compete with them. فَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسٍ مُتَنَافِسُونَ This is what we need to compete with each other in. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Allah looks at your competition. Musa and Isa and Dawud and Muhammad and Abdullah are all striving in the recitation of the Quran. Muhammad is looking, and Abdullah is praying one Quran, I'm going to try to pray two, inshallah. Abdullah is looking, he's praying two. Abdurrahman says, I'm going to try to pray three Quran, inshallah. Competing with each other in righteousness. But then again, let us remind ourselves, not was boasting. Are Musa, take it, look, I'm going to Well, Musa, how many? I've already prayed 10, mashallah. So now, you are showing arrogance. You're doing takabbur. You are wasting your effort. Huh? Because now, you're actually boasting to the people and saying, I've already prayed 10 Qur'an. How many have you prayed? You shouldn't reveal this. You should keep it concealed. Because Allah knows that. What kind of niyat you have in your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq for this, inshallah. Allah looks at our competition. Allah looks at our competition. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ajib Allah. Allah also boasts about us in front of the malaika, subhanAllah. And he says, look at my servants. My servants, they have got shahwa. They have got lust. They have got desire. But they kept a fast for me. And I am now going to reward them in person. Personal reward, subhanAllah. وَأَنَا أَجْزِيبِ أَصْطَوْمُنِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِيبِ His fast was for me. And I am going to reward my servant, inshallah. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who boasts about me and you in front of the malaika. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when this is a month of blessing, when Allah is going to forgive your sins, and Allah is going to accept your prayers, and Allah is looking at your competition, and Allah is boasting about you, where does that leave you now? Where does that leave you and me? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَأَرَوُ اللَّهَ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا O Muslim, O Abdullah, O Abdurrahman, O Fatima Zainab, فَأَرَوُ اللَّهَ Show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of your deeds, subhanallah. سب سے اچھے عمال کر کے اللہ کو بتلاو. فَأَرَوُ اللَّهَ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا And Father Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِنَّ الشَّقِيِّ For who is the pitiable one? Who is the misfortunate one? فَإِنَّ الشَّقِيِّ مَنْ حَرُمَ فِيهِ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم The pitiable one, the misfortunate one is that person who is deprived of the rahmah and the mercy of Allah Rabbul Izzah even in this holy month of Ramadan. This is the person who is the misfortunate one. This is the person who is the pitiable one. Because he has lost and not gained anything in this holy month of Ramadan. Moving on. Today, Alhamdulillah, we recited Surah Yusuf in our Salatul Tarawih. And the whole story of Yusuf, Allahu Akbar. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي يُسُفَ وَإِخْوَتِهِ آيَاتٍ There's a lot of signs. Lots of lessons to be learned from the story of Yusuf. A lot of lessons. And the ulama and the mufassirin say, the whole story of Yusuf alayhi salam, its conclusion is in one ayah. And that ayah is, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِ وَيَصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ صدق الله العظيم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that person who has taqwa and who has patience and sabr this person the whole story of Yusuf is about saving himself the conscience of Allah Zulaykha is inviting him towards bad he's handsome he's got the strength he's in a castle and palace Nobody's there to say anything. Allah says in the Holy Quran, you know, this is the whole meaning. Allah has created lust and desire in us. The difference between me, you, and the malaika is quite simple. The malaika have been created by Nur. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They do not do disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The malaika have been created from the nur. Me and you are not created from nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us from clay and water and fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. And Allah has created us, and within us, Allah has created lust and desire and temptations and ambitions, and we have to go through trials and tribulations. This is insan. Allah has created me and you in such a mode, in such a way. Now that person who is blind, he can say, Alhamdulillah, I've never seen a woman in my life. Allah protected him from that sin, yes or no? Do you agree to me or not? People don't agree to me. That man who's blind has never seen a human being. Can he make a claim and say, I've never seen a woman in my life? Yes or no? MashaAllah, I think you people are ready to go to sleep. I better finish quick now. I've just started one of them. And that person who Allah has granted vision, me and you, and that person is faced with a dilemma, that he sees a beautiful woman and he puts his gazes down. La ilaha illallah. You tell me, is there a difference between these two people or not? Obviously, there's a great difference. That person who is blind, he has not got the capability of looking at a woman. Allah protected him from that sin. Yes, very fine, very well. But that person who had the capability of looking at a woman and then puts his gaze down, subhanAllah, Allah will reward that person. Same with malaika. They cannot disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they can never ever disobey Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boasts to the malaika and says, you are from nur, but these servants of mine, they had lust, they had a desire, but even then they protected themselves and they stayed hungry and thirsty only and only for myself, and I am going to reward them inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what we need to understand, that Allah has created in the story of Yusuf a lesson for us. And the lesson is quite simple and straightforward. We need to create the conscience of Allah at all times. We need to have taqwa in our libas. Libasul muttaqin. We need to have taqwa in our salah. We need to have taqwa in our zakah. We need to have taqwa in our qurbani. We need to have taqwa in our hajj. Everything Allah has mentioned in the Quran, at the end of the day, He mentions that I want piety from you. I want taqwa. Everything we look at. وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهُ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ الحج. What does Allah say? وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّالِكَ تقوى. Allah says regarding zakat, لَعَلَّهُ يَزَّكَّى. Allah, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَطْقَى الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, numerous places of the Holy Quran has informed me and you, my brother and sister in Islam, regarding the importance of the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Coming back to the point of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is a very important time in the month of Ramadan. First Ashara has gone now. Allahu Akbar. The first Ashara has gone away from us. We're going to keep the 10th fast inshaAllah tomorrow. Now we've only got maybe less than 20 days or maybe 20 days. Allah knows best. Yeah? Every day is precious. Every day an announcement is made. And what's the announcement? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in a hadith which has been recorded by Imam Tirmidhi rahimahumullah in his Sahih, in his Jami', he says, When the first night of Ramadan comes, صفدت الشياطين ومرضت الجن. The devils are chained and the evil jinns are chained. And then what happens? Allah opens all the doors of Jannah, subhanAllah. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ فَلَمْ يُغْلَقْ مِنْهَا بَابٌ. Not even one door of Jannah is closed, subhanAllah. And then, وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ. Every door of Jahannam is locked, subhanAllah. Every door of Jahannam is locked. فَلَمْ يُفْتَحْ مِنْهَا بَابٌ. Not even one door is left open of Jahannam. وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ. An announcer makes an announcement. يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْتِرْ وَلِلَّهِ أُتَقَاءُ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, an announcement is made, O seeker of righteousness, O seeker of goodness and khair, go forward in the worship of Allah. And all that person who has got, who is the seeker of evil, stop yourself, for this is a very blessed month. The severeness, the severeness of a sin in this holy month of Ramadan goes much more than a normal day. When we do one khayr, we are rewarded with one faraz. We do one faraz, we are rewarded with 70 faraid. In the same, if we do one sin, the severeness of that sin goes greater in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a month, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, where we need to strive hard. For every day this announcement is made, go forward, O seeker of goodness. Stop yourself, O seeker of evil. For Allah has got many people who He frees from the hellfire in this holy month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who have been given freedom from the hellfire on the day of Qiyamah, inshaAllah. Allah give us the tawfiq to understand the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's one riwayah which I would love to mention to you today regarding those things which we need to do in abundance. It's a lengthy hadith which has been recorded by Allama Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahumullah in his Sahih, which has also been mentioned by Hazrat Sheikh Zakariya rahimahumullah in Fawaid A'mal. I would request brothers to try and look up this hadith which has been mentioned in Fawaid A'mal by Hazrat Zakariya rahimahumullah ta'ala, a lengthy hadith which has got many, many lessons. And then in the end, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in that hadith, there are four things which we need to do in abundance. Two things which we can please our Lord, and two things which we've got, we can never claim to be need-free. Two things which we can please our Lord is do the zikr of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Bulabai, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Many times people think it's a sin, saying the zikr of Allah in masjid. Let me tell you one riwayah which is narrated by Imam Ahmad rahimahumullah in his Musnad, Sahih Hadith. And that, this has also been recorded by Hazrat Sheikh Zakariya rahimahumullah in Fadail A'mal. We tend to think, oh, zikr of Allah, we're not going to do a zikr. When the poor people go to see a football match, and they chant, Leicester City, and they say Manchester United, Liverpool, and they're chanting away, and they're blowing their voices loud and clear, and they're screaming their heads off. They don't feel shy there. But when it comes to mentioning Allah's name in the house of Allah, they look at each other's faces and say, "Yeh Maulvi kahab bol raha hai? Why is he telling us to say the name of Allah?" Let me tell you a hadith of Rasulullah, and I will conclude on that, inshaAllah. Hazrat Ya'la ibn al-Shaddad radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Ya'la ibn al-Shaddad radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, "Haddathani abi Shaddad ibn Awsin." My father, Shaddad ibn Aws, told me, وَعُبَادُ ibn Samit حَاضِرٌ يُصَدِّقُ. Who is verifying this incident? Hazrat Ubad ibn Samit was present there, and he was verifying this incident. And what does he say? كنا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were seated by Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were seated with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said one day, هل فيكم غريب? Is there a stranger here? Is there anybody, meaning to say, was there a non-Muslim there? هل فيكم غريب? Is there a stranger here? قلنا لا يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Sahaba said, Rasulullah, there is no stranger here. فأمر بغلق الأبواب. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, close the doors. What did he say? Close the doors. فأمر بغلق الأبواب. دروازه بند کرو. Meaning to say, Allah, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم knew from Allah that those people that were present there, these are the only ones which are going to get the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since فأمر بغلق الأبواب. Close the doors. And after closing the doors, what did he say? إِرْفَعُوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ Raise your hands. وَقُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَقُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ He says, raise your hands and say, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَرَفَعْنَا أَيْدِيَنَا سَاعَةً The Rawi says, we raised our hands for a little while and we did a zikr of Allah. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ سُنَّت کی نیت سے پڑھ لے بھائی میرا ذرف ہو انشاءاللہ میرا پار ہو جائے گا انشاءاللہ لا الہ الا اللہ لا الہ الا اللہ لا الہ الا اللہ لا الہ الا اللہ حضرت سے that فرفعنا ایدینا ساعتا we raised our hands for a little while and we did a ذکر of Allah with رسول اللہ صلى الله عليه وسلم thereafter رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said الحمد لله what did he say? Thanks to Allah الحمد لله اللهم إنك بعثتني بهذه الكلمة ووعدتني عليها الجنة Oh Allah you have sent me with this kalima لا إله Illa Allah. Every prophet came with this kalima. We say there in the Alhamdulillah. When we give da'wah and tabligh, we say, Har Nabi ne kaha, Qulu la ilaha illallah, Suflehu. Are la ilaha illallah, bol do, kamyab ho jaoge. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Innaka ba'athani bihadihi al-kalima. You have sent me with this kalima. La ilaha illallah. Wa wa'athani alaiha al-jannah. And you have promised me upon this kalima al-jannah and paradise wa innaka la tukhlifu al-mi'ad wa anta la tukhlifu al-mi'ad and you will never ever break your promise O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this was the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at the sahaba and he says abshiru abshiru Good glad tidings, and I want to give you some good news. Abshiru, قد غفر الله لكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven your sins. Subhanallah. Huh? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Abshiru, glad tidings to you people who said, لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله. This zikr of لا إله إلا الله. Said, you have said it. Inshallah, if we say it with this intention, maybe Allah will also forgive us, inshallah. For following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I went away from the track. Four things which we need to do, zikr of la ilaha illallah and istighfar. Two things we need to save ourselves from, and we can, which we can never claim to be need-free, is that we ask Allah for Jannah, and we ask His protection from the hellfire. These are the four things which we need to do in abundance, in the holy month of Ramadan. Protect yourselves, abstain from sins. If we sin, we will deprive ourselves of the mercy of Allah. The example of that person who sins is like when it's heavy rain outside, you will go out, your clothes will get wet. But if you have an umbrella, it's going to stop the rain. In the same way, when you sin, this sinning will become a barrier between the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descending on you. So make a firm resolution that inshallah, And ye niyat pakki kar lo. Allah, give me the tawfiq to abstain from sins forever, inshallah. Forever. Make this niyat. اللہ مجھے گناہوں سے ہمیشہ اپنے آپ کو بچانے کی توفیق عطا فرما. If we make this intention, the barakah of that will be Allah will protect you from doing sins inshallah for the rest of the year inshallah. But it needs us to make this firm intention and firm resolution that we will not sin. And secondly, give your time towards the worship of Allah in this holy month. May Allah give me and you the proper understanding of what has been said. And may He also give us all the tawfiq to do amal and what has been said. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh. Wa sallallahu ala al-Nabi al-Kareem. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. سبحانك الله بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا.